I am Jeff Yarger. I'm a professor of chemistry, biochemistry, and physics at Arizona State University. In this video, we're covering Tinoco, chapter number 2, and we're making a video to cover a specific end of the chapter problem, and specifically problem number 20 we're going to look at. In this video, we're not going to work it explicitly. Instead, we're going to motivate it so that any students having problems with this explicit problem or kind of any related problem, there's a lot of problems and examples related to the thermodynamics of water and specifically thermochemistry with work and heat changes in these processes. And oftentimes its heat is looked at isobarically through, in a sense, what its change in enthalpy is, which we've defined and looked at rigorously in chapter 2. So what we're gonna do, if you're having problems with something like any of these problems or problem 20 explicitly, I'm hopefully gonna be able to give you a video that will allow you to think about this problem and work it, and I'll subsequently make a separate video, a short one, that explicitly works it and comes up with the final answer in this one, on this specific problem. So what is problem 20 in chapter 2 of Tinoco? And it's in the 5th edition. It says that you have 100 grams of water at 55 degrees Celsius, and you mix it, or in a sense, like I always like to set up these problems by kind of drawing it. And so you mix it with 10 grams of ice at minus 10. And basically, what's the final temperature is the question. So it gives you one caveat that you're meant to do this at constant pressure. That's not too surprising. We often look at things at atmospheric pressure. It doesn't say what pressure, but we kind of assume that it's one bar. We don't really need that for this problem. But it's really stating that no heat is allowed to leave the system or that it's adiabatic. So I like to think of this in practical terms. If we took an adiabatic vessel or basically, a Dewar'd container and we put 100 grams of water in there and then we threw a chunk of ice in at, that was 10 grams, right? And it's asking, what is the thermodynamics of that process? So what's the final temperature? The ice started at minus 10 degrees and it's 10 grams of it. And the water, started at 55 degrees Celsius and there's 100 grams of it, which is, fairly reasonable. So, 100 mils of water or so and a little bit of ice, right? So what you end up with. So so we have a fair amount of water and just a little bit of ice. Now, one of the things that you first have to realize with this problem, and then I think it confused people. So the first thing you think of in this is because it's at a fixed temperature or a fixed pressure, the change in pressure is zero, then the change in heat is equal to the change in enthalpy, which is equal to zero. So the overall delta H of this process is zero. But the first thing we have to do before we can think of what to do with the final temperature, the real caveat in this one is if two things are in the same phase, so if you're just taking cold water and warm water and mixing them together, then you can just set the CP delta T for, the cold one, absorbing heat, the CP delta T of the hotter liquid releasing heat, equal to each other so that the overall enthalpy is zero and solve for the temperature. But this, the caveat is it's part of it's undergoing a phase change, right? So really what's happening with the ice, right, is that as soon as you put it in something, it's going to start, absorbing heat, from the water, which is going to decrease the temperature of the water, and it's going to absorb it until the ice gets to 0 degrees. So it's going to start, right here at 263 Kelvin, right? And I've grabbed this figure from the book. And the reason is because I find a figure like this to be very helpful in kind of understanding the problem and setting it up. So like I said, this one is all about setting up the problem and understanding it. And we'll make a short video so that you can watch this and try to work it yourself. And I'll make another one that just goes through all of the systematics of plug and chugging the variables. So really what the ice is doing is going from 263 up to 273. So it's absorbing heat from, you can't absorb it from the outside because it's adiabatic. You can't bring in heat from the surroundings. You can only transfer heat, it has to overall stay zero from the internal parts of the system, which are these two components. So at the same time, you're sitting there at, 55, so 328 K, 73, so this one is, gonna start decreasing temperature, but you can tell, like, A, this heat capacity is more, so it's not gonna take much heat at all to get up to here. You're not gonna decrease the temperature of this much. The other thing is the disparity in the amount. You have 10 times less of this. So it's kind of like taking this here and making it, a factor of 10 smaller, right? So, and making this slope smaller. So really, in this having to warm up to here didn't change the temperature much at all. Now you have ice at 0 degrees. So your little ice cube is at 0 degrees Celsius. And there's, 10 grams of it. And what you're gonna do is convert the ice into liquid water. And that's gonna give you, that's gonna absorb heat and it's gonna take it away from here as the delta H of fusion. And you're gonna melt all 10 grams of it. Now, like I said, the first thing is to figure out the final state. Well, if you scale this down a factor of 10 and this slope, you can easily tell just graphically that that you're not gonna end up at a final state that's a mixture of 0 degrees water and ice. You're gonna have enough, you're gonna be able to absorb enough heat out of the 100 grams of water at 55 to melt that entire thing of ice. So now you have 10 grams of liquid water at 0 degrees, along with a slightly cooler 100 grams of water. And that, now we can easily mix together and figure out the overall final temperature of that water mixture, which is now, 110 grams. So in a sense, what you're setting up is the heat capacity delta T here, the heat capacity delta T here, which ends up being opposite, and you can tell that by just what the change in temperature is. This one, the final temperature is colder than warmer. This one you're gonna do up to zero, so you're gonna do from, a final state of 273, and an initial state of 263, right? And then you're gonna go through you're gonna add the delta H of fusion to get all of it to water, and then the 10 grams here. So you can see, what you're gonna do. Now, the problem is that if this was 100 grams of this, this would be to scale. You're gonna have to scale this down because of the amount, right? And so I can, just looking at this, like I said, kind of make a prediction, which is because you have so little ice and it's basically a factor of 10 smaller than this, right? So it's only gonna be, instead of 6 kilojoules, it's basically 0.6 kilojoules per mole, and we have 10 grams, so less than a mole of it. We're basically gonna cool the overall system, is gonna be water, at a temperature of, probably about 10 to 15 degrees colder than 55, because you're gonna use that much heat to take this ice, warm it to zero, melt it, and then get the 10 grams heated up to where it's under equilibrium where all 110 grams are at one final temperature. And like I said, I can, you know, just kind of estimate based on looking at this graph that it's roughly going to be, you know, 10 to 15 degrees colder. So what I encourage you to do is now take the values, knowing that you're under adiabatic conditions, so that the overall, you're going to set each of these individual enthalpies, you're going to, of the process, you know, where it's the enthalpy change here, and then this one here, and then the combination of this one here is all going to be set to zero. And what you're going to be solving for, you're going to know most of the final temperatures except the final temperature of the water. And so you're going to, in a sense, be solving for the final temperature where you'll know all your other initial final temperatures. And like I said, like that you're going to be able to calculate what the final temperature is. But what you needed to know ahead of that was where the final state is. And that's easy to just graphically see here, that with such a small amount of ice that that the final state is liquid water. So I hope this helps you intuitively understand better the problem. And like I said, we'll make another short video where we plug and chug the numbers here to get an exact final temperature, which, like I said, I can already estimate to be, you know, 10 to 15 degrees below 55 Celsius. Thank you.